originally going to be called, Just Past Point of Breaking. Yeah. And it kind of, I think, lyrically, and even and in terms of the music of it, it kind of summed up where we were at the time when we were writing this album. It's also like a sort of preview of all the different styles of music that are on the album. I think the album's fairly diverse from start to finish, but it's sort of like the jumping off point where you listen to that and you kind of you get in this mindset for the rest of the album. Maybe all these chips
in me designed for you and I. That was the first song we wrote when we locked ourselves up down in Ross's house in Hurlford. That was the first song we wrote where I was like, yeah, we've started to write this album properly now.
Yeah.
We all had that kind of feeling. It was like, this is it. This is the start of how this album's going to sound. And we were thinking, are we too late? Do we miss the boat? Can we just at the point of breaking? Just past the point of fixing?
Yeah, always is like, when that was coming together, I was like, I'm not really sure, like, what this is. Like, it's got like an 80s guitar intro, and like, swooping guitars, like, dive bombing and stuff all over the intro. I never, like, it just kind of came out of nowhere. I would have never have pictured it.
Yeah.
Like if you went, you know, go write a song, I would never have done that twice.
It's got a real moody vibe about it in a way that a lot of our songs don't. They're very sort of vocal led and like this is sort of the darkest I think the record gets. Listen to the silence.
Listen to the silence. Lost Little Boys probably started, like there's maybe only two songs on it that have maybe come forward from ideas we've had over the last 18 months or something, like the 18 months prior to recording. It's a cold summer's night. Are you
beside me? I can't tell. Jason Perry brought a lot to that song as well, with the big gang vocals and like that really give it that kind of lift that it didn't quite have when we demoed it. And then I think that was the first time I'd felt like working with a producer. It's like, wow, this has really lifted this song up to this sort of next level that we just wouldn't have thought about by ourselves. Yeah, you owe me that, cause we are just lost
little boys. Making a name.
The verses, the drum beat had been existing for quite a wee while. We'd sort of written it on another song a few months before, but it didn't quite work. That song never really went anywhere, so we lifted that beat and put it into the verses. And then in Rockfield there's got great big reverb chambers, so we overdubbed the drums again and passed them through that. Remember, that was excellent fun. So they sounded really, really big and kind of, they almost sound sort of 80s distorted kind of toms in the end. These
days. And then it had that big, the middle eight.
Yeah, it goes into a sort of rudiment style drum part at the end that we've layered up quite a few times just on the kit when we were tracking it. And then, was it Jason's idea to take it outside?
To do a bin. Oh, we wanted to record, because we recorded it almost like a marching band as well. Yeah. Did all the drums outside because it was a big courtyard where we were recording. So did it all out there, and then I think was it Jason's idea about the bin, your idea?
I found a bin out the back, sort of around the back of the studio, and I was like, let's definitely hit this this bin.
Wonders how it started off life as a song I wrote in my mum and dad's house about 6 months after I'm an Island came out. Wrote this song and pure loved it, and then we demoed it and it was just this like quiet wee song with hardly any drums in it and hardly any anything in it, and then it turned into this crazy jungle dance song. It's not really a jungle dance song, but it's just
it's definitely the most different sounding song on the album. Do you have a wondrous heart? Do you have the guts to tell me that everything I ever did was wrong? It just ended up being like a big jam, because Bruce, who was the producer on the album, was in with us, and him and Jason, and we all just like, we're on different instruments. It kind of almost breathes a lot, a kind of just a different life into it.
Yeah, definitely. She tries her best, but she still don't know where everything she's lost is when, and she's lost the faith in common sense. But she tries her best, and you know. Joanna is a song I wrote when I was a couple of hours early for work. When did you notice that I wasn't here? I cried out for ages, but no one appeared. I remember just doing it as a voice memo, like having one pass at it. I think in the inception of some stuff, I like just sitting with voice memos and just doing like a stream of consciousness. Like, it doesn't need to be anything, but just like mess around for 5 minutes. Been crying out for so long, maybe I need this
love. Joanna, Joanna. We did, recorded the demo and sent it to everyone that works with us, and I think everyone kind of instantly fell in love with it. It just really kind of seemed to resonate with everyone that listened to it. And then we went back into the studio and we recorded it and listened to it back, and it was the, we had some folk around to listen. It was the first moment when we listened back to it, and everyone kind of sat and went, right, that's good, but it's maybe not quite the same. And I think I got my phone out and just played the demo that we had of Joanna, and we're like, that's better. The demo, which was just us in a room set up, quickly recorded. We recorded, I think it was like 13 songs in 2 days at one point, and it just sounded great. So we just took the vocals from the demo, quite a lot of the guitars from the demo, the bass mostly from the demo, and that's what's on the album. Joanna, Joanna. Joanna, Joanna. There was nothing fancy about it, and yeah, it was definitely, I think, my favourite vocal on the whole album. It's 'cause I feel like I'm a castaway, just fading. And then it goes on to Yoga Days, which is like the most, like, it's just like a piano and a vocal. These are difficult times we find ourselves in. Do we really risk all that we have for it? In your vision of time, she said, we don't have any younger days left. A wise man once told me that if we build it, they will come. I always think when working out the track listing for an album, I think it's a really important thing, because people do listen to it from start to finish, but I always look at it like a set list. Like, if we're going to go and play a gig,
yeah,
you put songs a certain way because of how you want people listening or the crowd in terms of a set list to react. So you think about where the kind of big rock sing-along songs are, and you also think about the bit where if you're going to dip down and go something that's a little bit quieter, that's like a nice kind of almost break in the album, like where are you going to put that? And it feels like the right place in the way that it kind of goes down with Joanna and Younger Days.
I was down with no applause. Don't clap me out of the room.
We were thinking like we like albums in two halves and stuff like that, and we always wanted to be an album band that could write an album that would suit like people, because people listen on vinyl nowadays and people listen on shuffle and people like just stream things. So like, just to take you to that point where you're like, this act one is over and then the next one coming in and like blowing you away again.
Sometimes you'll find me, I'm reckless but easy.
I think Open Book is the coolest song on the album. Like, see when you go, that's a cool song.
Yeah.
You mean there's like, that's a really good song, that's a great song, I really like that song. But Open Book is like, that's really good.
The song starts with just Ross on the guitar, and when we were writing the song, I'd remember waiting because the tension's so much in that first sort of verse, and I remember thinking, should we come in now? Should me and Mark come in? No, let's leave it another time. And that tension is exactly what I like about the song, because it goes on just that bit longer than you want it to, and you're just so ready for it to drop, and when it does, it's just huge. Forest was a song that we wrote before we even knew we were writing a second album. We'd just written it because it happened when we were in the rehearsal room and we thought it was awesome. So before we knew we were writing an album, we thought, let's just put this song into the set list because we want to, because it's great. And it started immediately, pretty much as soon as we started to play it, people started asking us about it and what we're going to do with it, when can they hear it. When we knew we had the second album on the go, it's like, this has to be on it.
Yeah.
Straight away, this was like, before we'd written any other songs, like, Forest is going to be on this album.
Actually, the chorus from Forest happened the day we were shooting the video for Mine for Me, just like, stalling about
in a forest.
Yeah, literally in a forest.
But it's just, it's great fun. We've been playing it live for quite a while now, so anyone that comes to see us will kind of probably already be aware of that song. I'm really excited to let people hear the recorded version of that song, because I think it sounds great. Kids has a guitar solo in it, and if you come to a gig, you'll see Ross play a guitar solo.
Yeah, and I will love every second of it. Kids is actually, we talked about Wondrous Art being like the maybe the biggest departure from the first album. I would say the Kids. It's probably the biggest departure.
Strong and sentimental, and reminds me of those times when there was nothing left to lose and no one knew of broken hearts.
Kids, I think it's just kind of a good, fun rock song. It's going to be one of those ones that once we start playing it live, I think it's really going to come into its own.
Kids are losing their minds. These kids are losing their minds.
Stop the Car was a song that started off very differently from how it is on the album. It was, I think it was like a pop punk song at one point.
No, it totally was a pop punk song.
We had like a couple of our friends that came into the studio and were like, look, we've made a pop punk song. And then we all kind of realised, why did we make a pop punk song? Yeah. But it had some really cool elements of it, so we kind of stripped it back. And it's actually quite bare. Like, the intro and kind of what's under the chorus is just a single, it's a guitar line, and everything else is just following that. And the verses are kind of just bass drums, and it's got a Rhodes over it. It was a song that we kind of threw a lot of stuff at, and again then took it completely out of rehearsal room syndrome and went, let's just kind of strip it bare. Make time for that. Stop the car. Sleeping Over is the song to me that sounds like our time recording at Rockfield. I've never really been good at these
things. Like, did you know there's a reason why that place has been like a studio for so long?
Yeah, because
it sounds great.
I think Sleeping Over is just a song that didn't really need very much onto it.
I remember getting the demo back when we were playing a festival in the Netherlands, and it just sort of, we demoed it and I'd almost kind of forgotten about it, and then we got the mix back and it was just like, yeah, this is really right. We're just sleeping over.
I actually think it could be my favourite song on the album, and I couldn't tell you why, but every time I think about it, or every time it gets brought up, I like a beam inside.
Yeah,
and it might not be the most popular song on the album, it might not be the least, so it might never do anything, but for me, and I think for all of us, it's just got this weird...
It had a vibe that kind of encapsulated a lot of things that were going on at the time when
yeah.
it was written.
Yeah.
And totally. I think it was just telling a little story of stuff that was happening in everyone's lives.
Yeah.
And it's just, it's simple. It's one of the ones that we didn't need to do anything to. It sounds like us in a room playing a song from start to finish. You look right through me like you're chasing ghosts. Those little parts of me that no one knows. We're changing rapidly, but holding on to all those little things that made you strong. My ears are ringing with the sounds of you.
Chasing Ghosts started as a conversation I had with the taxi driver about Saturday nights. I was getting a taxi home and it took me ages and ages and ages to get a taxi. And I was like, you know, just finished work or something like that, and I was like, what, you know, I've been waiting here for like 45 minutes. He's like, oh mate, I've been chasing ghosts for the last 45 minutes. I was like, what do you mean? So I keep going for hires and they've disappeared. He's like, I've just chased ghosts all around the city. And I was like, that's a beautiful image. I'm opening up here. Still have that cloudiness behind my eyes. Just the idea of that sort of the loss of something is just quite powerful. And he just meant it in a flippant way, and I was like, that's just, they just really inspired me, and just went home, finally I'm on and wrote a tune. It just lies through a ghost I see sometimes. I'm opening up here. I mean, like, that song is the sort of look back to where things were and to where things are now. And it's This is the line in it, the chorus line is just, I'm opening up here. And I think it just, yeah, I think it closes off all that sort of stuff from the first album and just really gets the point across that everything's sort of laid bare on this album. When you make your mind up, I'll be waiting here in silence, still it's just that awkward moment between. We are three friends who have been making music together since we were kids, but over the last 3 or 4 years as father-son, we're in the most comfortable, happy place we've ever been musically, because we just get to cut about and just be pals and just have a great time. Like, it's an awesome way to spend time, and it's what we'd always envisage being in a band would be like when we were kids, and now we get to actually do that and go and see different countries and different places and play with bands we always idolise and play with bands that we like discover, and that is really what it's all about. And we are so happy this album's coming out because it means we get to do that for longer.